to talk.
So, we have just arrived back at Polzeath Beach, and it's around 2:30 in the afternoon, so we're hoping to do that view there, and so quite excited, looking at the reflections of the headland in the sand. The tide's going out, so we should be alright here. Let's go!
Static. Time for a cuppa yet? Is it time for a cuppa yet?
No. And the reflection of the bayside in the wet sand. I think it's about a 12 by 16, but I'm not sure. I've got so many sizes, I can't quite tell. But anyway, it doesn't matter. The thing that I do like, if you have a look, is that dark bit of steps, where the steps is. It's a nice dark tone in there. Otherwise, the tones are all very similar. So I'm going to try and get that dark bit in, because I think that works well. And there we go. Although, I don't know if I should be. I think it was good. I just think that my view here is that I'm cutting the steps off, but I don't think that matters. It's got that dark shadow, that's the important thing. I'm going to have a go at drawing it out. I use a mix of burnt sienna and yellow ochre to draw out with quite a stubby brush, which I like. I'm placing the horizon quite high because I want that reflection.
And what's on your board already?
Yes, and I've got a drawing out of a previous painting in Holywell. Also on the north coast of Cornwall. But I didn't like the composition, so I tried another board. It happens often. I'm just looking and I'm not sure whether there is too much sand at the bottom for the balance of it. So I'm going to have a go at just shifting down a small amount and seeing if that helps. Otherwise I'm going to try another board. Then I'm not going to like the painting, so I have to get it right or else it will just annoy me. And I'm happy. start mixing some colours, I think.
Yay!
Oh, boo. I just remembered I forgot my palette knife, so however organised you can be, you still forget things. So I'm just going to have to paint, mix with my brush, which is fine. It's better usually because you get, if you use a palette knife to mix your colours first, I tend to be able to put more paint on. I just remember to paint thickly. So when I'm starting something like that, I will look at the tonal values and look at the darkest darks and the lightest lights. I squint my eyes. And the shadow, obviously, where I was talking about where those steps are, that's the darkest darks. Probably the lightest lights is where the sun is catching the wave, breaking waves. So that gives me parameters of my tonal value. Sun is a little bit gone behind clouds, so hopefully it won't last. We'll get the sun back out again. I feel I need to cover some of the bigger areas first, so I'm going to put the sky in first. And that will help me then to set the value and the colour of the headland next to it. So cerulean blue is my friend. I use it a lot, probably too much. And also lemon yellow, which is a very clean kind of cool yellow, which does such a nice mix together. I'm going to put turpentine in, which is what's in my pot. And that makes my paint thinner. I don't want to use too much, so I'm only just dabbing it in. And then I do a little test, and I'd say that is too blue, too saturated, and too dark. So I've added more white, more lemon yellow, and a little bit of red to take the saturation down. So also, I can see that there is a different colour on the horizon, so I'm going to put that in as well. It's kind of like a warmish, bluish, reddish, it's kind of undeterminable, I think that's a word. Is that a word? Undeterminable.
Nice word.
We'll go with that. Quite hard to judge, but I'm going to just do a neutral colour at the bottom by mixing all my complementary colours together, so yellow, blue and red. And then try it. I'm going to push it towards the purple, I think. The violet. Just because it will look nicer. Take it off. I think it's definitely cool. It's not perfect. Another colour I use a lot is Naples Yellow Light. That's that one there. And I also use that for a lot for the sky as well. It's very useful because it's quite soft, you know, know, the lemon yellow is really powerful, but this one isn't. A lot more forgiving.
Looks nice.
Thank you, Mr. Cameraman. So it's much warmer than I expected today, this afternoon. This morning was bitter cold. It was frosty. I've got all my layers on. I've had to strip off some because it's so hot. I'm not complaining. You wouldn't believe it was January today. It's so nice. I'm putting the sky in quite roughly because I don't want it to be too perfect looking, and I want a kind of a bit of energy in it, my energy. I will probably add more paint to it a bit later. This is just the initial. I just realised I want to get that cloud in. So I'm going to take a bit out. So again, I'm using the complementaries. I do that a lot. I mix the complementary, the red, blue and the green together, because it gives a colourful neutral. I have to also watch the tonal value because it's very, very light. See, that's way too dark. Because there is wet sand below it, it's the reflection, it's like glass. So I'm just putting a little bit of the sky as we go along. I can add to it. But it helps me in a minute when I come to that. bit strong, that. I put some cobalt in, but I think it's possibly a bit strong.
Pretty.
Just going to take it down a little bit. It's a warmer blue. You can see the difference. It's a lot warmer than a cerulean blue, which is a very cool blue. It's got a lot of yellow in the cerulean. Some of that cloud in now. While it's there, so I remember what it looks like. So, quite often you think clouds are white. Obviously they're not. Depends on the time of the day and the light on them. And today, when I squint my eyes, they are light, but they're not as light as the sea, the waves. So I have to remember that, because if I go too light with them, then the waves won't show up like they should. That bit, I'm going to just do a bit more of this. It's good to do it together because you remember what you've done, and it is kind of echoing. This is echoing this. Sometimes I go back in and do a bit of the sky so it marries up. No. Come back in a bit. There's a reflection of that. I'm using my mix, my red, yellow, blue again, this time Scarlet Lake, Cadmium Yellow and Cerulean. It's got quite a lot of red in that headland, it's quite warm, even though it's at distance. So I've flicked my eyes between that and what I'm looking at. Yeah. I think it's still a bit warmer. variations of green on there. I'm not going to be too fastidious with it, but I will change it a little bit. Putting too much detail in for the moment, I'm just putting the general shapes. I suppose having the different brushes allows me to keep my colours clean. One of the reasons I do it. Other people have the same brush for the whole painting. There's no right or wrong in it. It's just preference. So I've got to remember not to make it too dark because it's quite a long way away. Or too saturated in colour for the same reason. Distance and see what we can do. When you look at the two colours on here on my palette, you know how strong in tone, light and dark, and also in saturation in colour. Is compared to these, which is my distant ones, but I don't know if I've done the distant ones too light at the moment, too kind of milky, so we'll see. we discussed earlier, that dark colour in the where the steps are over there, where those people are. I'm just mixing it to try and get something that works. With my darks, I try not to go too thick to start with, so they sit better when they're thinner. Otherwise, they come forward too much. Similar tones. So now I've got, you know, a dark mix, I'm now going to go through and see if I can find any other darks that I can put in. Putting the darks in now because if I do it over the lights, then they're never dark enough. So it's good to get them in before you put the lights in. I'm also changing the colour slightly as I go because they're not the same colour shadows and darks. That I'm going away, I don't want it to be quite so strong. Stand out too much. Those people on there are quite fun. I'm going to take a photo just in case they will stand up quickly. I'm breaking out a little bit of colour, but I'm not at that stage, so if I can try and get it in quickly, we'll see. Often happens when you're plein air painting that something happens and you want to get it in. Mm-hmm. so I'm still working on them, even though they're moving. That lady with the purple jacket, she was sitting down.
I
were
you?
I did wonder if, yeah, thanks. Oh god, we are going to be part of the Polzeath house.
That's fantastic.
Oh,
that's amazing. That's in oils, obviously.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
Really?
Oh my god.
There's a bed now.
Yeah. I'll take a picture of that, Gaz.
Are you on Instagram?
Yes, and you are, say, don't you?
Yes,
yeah. There you go, so you look it up. Oh, there
yeah.
we go. Do you want to take a picture of it, Glazer?
Of course, go ahead.
It's lovely. How long was that going to take?
Probably another hour.
Oh, really? Right, okay. Yeah. Just the sun's going down. Yeah.
Lovely evening to do it.
I know, it's beautiful.
Very nice, yeah. Excellent. The best
just,
of luck.
Just be smiling. Yeah, you're looking lovely. Oh,
lovely. Nice to meet you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
So I'm just going to put the sea in because it's receding, it's going out, and I want to do it as it is now. So I'm just about to put the sea in again. Here we are. So the sea colour, there's a greeniness to it, but also the colour's reflecting from the sky. I'm going to put in a thin layer first of green, and then I'm going to put the blue over the top. The waves are so gorgeous. When the waves break, they're actually quite greeny colour. I'm going to do this as like an underpainting. And then put stuff on the top. It's coming together. I'm now feeling like I need to do that.
What?
Oh, sorry, the headland into there. So it feels as though that kind of needs to be done. Use a brush that I used. It's quite warm. Follow the shape. This area here is just such a beautiful light. I don't know if you can see it up there. It's just really gorgeous. So I'm going to try and get that right now before it changes. Running out of clean brushes. And clean space. spaces. Mental note not to forget my palette knife again. Quite strong colours, but that's maybe a bit too strong. Okay, so there's a kind of a yellow at the top. I just put a little bit of white and blue to bring it down. The sun is catching it as well. It feels like I'm kind of against the time because the sun's going down.
And there's clouds.
And there's clouds. Whether it's in light or not, or in shade, and that is in light. Tricky because it's so many colours in there, you have to simplify it or else it looks all a bit dizzy. So I'm just going to do that quite simple on there. Alright, it's coming. I think now this is very important, the water. So let's go back to it. Sky colour, but darker than the sky, and that tonal value. The red helps it not be so bright. So I'm kind of letting some of the colour show through.
And the green.
The underneath colour, the green. quite rough with the waves. It keeps catching my eye. Anyway, alright. The waves. So they need to be bright, quite bright and perky.
Honing in on perkiness.
Okay. So I'm making them cool to start with, and then I'm going to put. See how it looks. Yeah. You know when something keeps grabbing you, I can't bear it. It's not right, that. Too complicated. So I'm just simplified it a bit. Alright, back to waves. So there's a lot of lines of waves. The surf. So I have to make sure I've got quite a lot of paint. You see that on my brush? It's a soft brush, so it's a Pro Art Sterling, which is quite useful for kind of soft things like waves, soft shapes. It's coming.
What next?
Well, I'm still not happy with that, so I am going back into it and just trying to get the feel of all that energy in that water. That's what I want. So I'm going to have another go. I think I've been too tentative, maybe, I don't know. It's very difficult to capture. I'm going to make it a bit more. Lovely bit of colour in here. It's really light. When it's cold, the paint goes a little bit sticky. So it makes it quite hard to move around.
You goes what? See,
it goes sticky. The paint goes sticky because of the cold. And it does make it harder to move around. I really don't like that sea and I can't scrape it off! Oh my god!
normally I would just scrape that off and do it again. Swimmingly, and they almost paint themselves. Other times I'm wiping off the whole time. You wouldn't know at the end that that's happened. But it's just part of it, really. And this underneathness, you know, this doing that, it still can make it, you know, quite interesting. So. Squint the eyes, let's see what's happening. It's actually really light. It's changed a bit. I'm going to paint it how it is at the moment, I think. Hello, little one. Hi.
Do let's.
Yes. Okay, I'm going to paint it now, so hopefully that will work with the rest of it. So when you're struggling, somebody says that really helps. yeah, it's always a bit of a boost when somebody says you're right. Oh, thank God.
Can't hear you.
Alright, so let me see if I can get this C. Quite big shadow, I think, now. It has changed. Just at home if I'm not happy with it. Let me see. It's coming. Ish. Problem is, it's the light's going, so it's changing a lot. And the tide going out. It's a gift. The waves are going in a different direction. I know, I'm saying excuses. why it's not working. Anything, but you just have to kind of be patient and try different options with it. I think that's okay, it's better than it was. Do you think so?
Mm-hmm. Mm.
That wasn't the road. Definitely,
yes. Well, you've still got lines showing through from the underdrawing.
Lady in that yellow jacket was just amazing.
She's coming back.
Oh yes, here she comes. Nice. Thank you.
She's coming towards us.
Oh. I can still look at her colour though. I think she's blue travel. Her legs are a bit big. I can adjust when I put the paint down. There we are. Okay. Right, I think we need to fill the gaps in before the sun goes. I try to fill in all the gaps so I can tell whether the painting's working or not. I think this is a little bit strong. Now that I'm going to put the sand in under here, this needs to be softened. So I'm just going to go back over it a little bit. So I'm putting a bit of the kind of the blue in with it to marry it with the sky. You can't see it, but there is a rock in the foreground here, and I think that should be put in. So I'm just going to that in because it's quite nice and strong. Stones in and stuff, you can see. Helps with this foreground area. Losing the light, sadly, but I'm going to carry on for a little bit longer just to get this beach in. So the shape has changed quite a lot. This is where I wish I'd done this earlier. Oops, just gone over there. Definite line over the side of the things. Just want to just get that in and then we'll call it a day.
Wet sand has dried, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's changed so much, it's quite difficult to do now.
Yay!
So, I haven't finished this, but I think it's enough to now work in the studio with it. It was quite challenging. There was more to it than I thought there were, especially with the limited time. But I hope that it's been helpful and you've enjoyed this video. And do subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to see more. Thanks!